Have you ever wondered why bees die after stinging you, knowing that they're famous with their suicidal tactics? You're not alone if you're surprised by this, but you saw it with your own eyes, so you know it's true, right? But bees don't have a death wish. Well, no one does. In today's video, I'd like to clear everything up for you so that you can understand bees better. Welcome to Animals Wow TV. So why do bees die after stinging you? Let's get started. I know most of the people are very confused about whether these bees die after they sting. The misunderstanding arises from the fact that some stinging insects, such as wasps, can sting many times while most bees die after stinging. But do bees really die when they sting a human or an animal? We can push it further and ask, starting with what happens when a bee stings. When the tiny assassin stings, these lancets puncture the victim's skin, but the bee cannot draw them out. The bee sting is considerably more dramatic. It'll turn into this. This! Be sure that after getting stung, you'll find stingers buried in your skin, along with part of the bee's abdomen. Look at that closely. The stinger of a bee injects poison into the victim when it stings. For several minutes, the stinger that's left behind continues to inject chemicals into the person or animal. That's why, if at all possible, a bee sting should be removed immediately. The sooner they can be taken out, the better. As long as it's in the skin, it'll continue to pump poison. And at the end of it all, the area around the sting will turn red, and I assure you, it'll itch like hell. However, among all bees out there, only the honeybee is capable of stinging, and the only tiny assassin who dies afterwards. This is due to the honeybee stinger, which is famous for its barbed formation. The stinger of the honeybee remains trapped in your skin, and as the bee tries to fly away, the stinger breaks out of the body, killing the bee. Unfortunately, because the stinger is linked to the bee's abdomen, a portion of this, as well as a portion of the digestive tract, is lost. The bee is plainly killed as a result of his impulsive defense against you. Now, you might be wondering, why would a bee sting you if it were going to die afterwards? Or whether the bee is even aware that it'll die after stinging. But I am most curious, why are honeybees destined for such an epic misfortune? Do bees know they die when they sting? Their biology has always been blamed, but it has a lot more to do with us than it does with them. Those who work with bees believe that the bee is well aware that stinging will result in death, and that it'll only sting as a last option, which they think is the best choice. Honeybees will go about their business most of the time, visiting flowers, gathering nectar and pollen. After all, they're very busy creatures. They don't have time to play with you and they don't have the temperament to. If you serve them as a threat, be sure you're ready for the defense. Nuh-uh. Bees will not sting you or other animals. They'll only sting if they detect a direct threat to itself or its territory. See? They won't bother you if you don't bother them. But why didn't bees develop a sting that's removable from a mammal's skin? Surprisingly, from an evolutionary perspective, it makes sense for a single bee to perish when stung, because the hive's defenders do not reproduce. The only way they can ensure reproduction is to preserve the hive and its reproductive members. Wait, what? Worker bees don't reproduce? They don't get down with the bomb chicka wow wow? Yes, absolutely. Worker bees are the colony's disposable troops, whose primary purpose is to collect nectar, pollinate, and defend the hive. All female worker bees are sterile. All eggs are laid by the queen bee and the drones fertilize them. Swarming is a process in which a bee population splits in half and one half leaves the hive to establish a new colony somewhere else. Another question, is there another way a bee can survive after stinging? As you can see, the stinger of a honeybee is left behind after it's been used. Just imagine your abdomen, digestive tract, nerves, and muscles are left behind when you run away. Will you still survive such a massive internal injury? Well, that's the same thing with bees. The bee will die as a result of the tremendous tear, as it will not be able to survive the trauma. Other species of bee can also sting multiple times as their stingers aren't barbed, like wasps and bumblebees who have stingers that don't get stuck in human skin. Since the worker bees are in charge of defense, they are the only kind of bees that actually can sting. Differently to drones, which are the male bees, the queen bee only stings when fighting for dominance against another queen. I can make it simple for you to understand that the cost of losing some workers is worth it for them to improve their ability to fight against honey and larvae thieves to ensure the survival of the whole colony. Although, defense mechanisms are supposed to aid self-preservation. So what's the point of stinging if it leads to a bee's tragic death? The misunderstanding arises because the great majority of people believe that honeybee characteristics apply to all bees. Most bees don't die when they sting you, and they aren't supposed to. Honeybees are the only ones that have used this catastrophic method of self-defense. Every other bee could sting you multiple times and live to tell the tale of your suffering. You know these bees are savage, too. They can watch you all day suffering from this not-so-horrible sting. Now, when you encounter bees around, be sure you're not a threat. You may have heard that if you try to escape, bees will attack you. And this is true in some cases. Bees are very protective of their hive and would fight to the death to defend it. If they perceive you as a threat as you approach, they may start buzzing about your head angrily. This is why many beekeepers utilize smokers to calm the bees before they enter the hive or operate around it. Your first instinct may be to panic if you come across a hive and the bees begin buzzing around your head and face. However, because this is a quick movement that is seen as a direct threat, it's not suggested. I suggest backing away from furious bees gently and without making any sudden movements, preferably. Even if the bees are swarming around you, don't thrash your arms, as this will simply aggravate them and potentially result in you being stung. Remember this, if you don't bother them, they won't bother you. So the next time you encounter a beehive, just remember these points, and who knows, you might save yourself from being stung and you can save the bees too. Alright, that's it for today guys. If you enjoy watching this video, don't forget to smash that like and subscribe button for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and take care.